If you go to San Francisco, where the cable cars are, be sure to wear a flower in your hair. You could wear a rose bush in your hair, nobody would stare. Well, hello there, Malt Manhattans. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 156, and a big thank you to johnlamond.com, Master of Malt, for assisting me in introducing this extensive series of reviews of American spirits. Before we get stuck into this rather excellent bourbon here on my right-hand side, on your left, in Whiskey Review 154, I reviewed Dalwhinnie, the highest distillery in Scotland. Now, a few of my Facebooky malt makes, and you can find me on Facebook, Ralphie Mitchell. Happy to link up, guys. Happy to link. Sharing the knowledge. A few of my pals there said, Ralphie, Braeval is higher than Dalwhinnie. There seemed to be a bit of a debate about it, so I emailed Ordnance Survey, who do all the maps, the official maps in the UK. And I said, Dear Ordnance Survey, could you settle a misunderstanding and confirm, according to OS Maps, which is the highest whisky distillery in Scotland in metres, Dalwhinnie or Braeval? And the answer came back very promptly, so thank you, Kevin, for that at Ordnance Survey. The Ordnance Survey database shows Dalwhinnie with a height of 354.9 metres and Braeval at 351.8 metres. This would place Dalwhinnie Distillery higher than Braeval. So, guys, all sorted, and thanks very much. Next, time to pour some bourbon. I was about to say whiskey there. When you're getting into a new spirit for the first time, here we go, have a look at the label. You need to get your bearings. It's very tempting just to nip into your local liquorist store, shop, off sales, whatever you call it in your country, and say, a bottle of American bourbon, thank you very much, goodbye. But it's a bit more complex if you're wanting to really learn about the spirit. You really want to start with a good, particularly good example, and use that as your baseline or your benchmark bottle by which you're assessing and rating all others. So to understand the other consecutive bourbons, you have a glass side by side with your baseline bourbon. This is the one that sets the standard, and Elijah Craig, very 12-year-old, very successfully sets the standard for a lot of whiskey drinkers that I know. Also, online couldn't be easier. If you want to learn about American spirits, if you want to learn about bourbon, whiskey, and rye, you've just got to ask yourself one question: what does John know? Question mark. The John in question is John Hansel, editor of the Malt Advocate magazine. And if I were to ever buy whisky magazines, that is the magazine I would buy, Malt Advocate. Some very good writers, including Dave Broom. John has a sort of hybrid blog thing going on. It's really rather good. Not only is he usually the first to be reviewing new products, new liquors in the United States, but he seems to be fairly consistent with them and quite articulate in his comments, criticisms, so you're learning a wider aspect of the particular spirit. So it's very easy to find. You just Google what does John know, or go to maltadvocate.com. Moving on, Elijah Craig. Who was he? He was a reverend in the 18th century. And he was a bit of a philanthropist. He and his travelling Baptist church headed out into the Midwest, settled in Kentucky, and opened a distillery. Well, you may, if you're going to have the spirit, if you're going to be moved by the spirit, you may as well be consuming the spirit. What, the Holy Spirit with the whole spirit? Yeah, fair dues. And he was very successful. He is credited, some say falsely, with pioneering the use of charred casks for the maturation of bourbon and some other liquors, but principally bourbon, in which the interior of a new-made American oak cask is exceedingly burnt until it is rather black and crisp, and this imparts charcoal, which is very good at filtering out the unpleasant bits and making it lovely and soft and adding that rich colour and all the rest of it. And it also activates the sweet notes, vanilla notes, and the flavour elements of the wood in the cask, which interacts with the spirit. Elijah Craig, this is available as a 12-year-old and an 18-year-old. Both are good. I picked the 12-year-old because it is available and it is very good quality, in my humble opinion. Produced by one of America's leading, if not the leading, independent distillery, Heaven Hill, who are responsible for organising the Kentucky Bourbon Festival. My spies in the field have been telling me, Ralphie, it's a good event. If you ever make it across, go. Well, I'll think about it. Notes. Where's my notes? Wait, I've just thrown my notes away with the Ordnance Survey thing. Excuse me. Now, with whiskey, because I'm normally reviewing whiskies, you know, and I don't, by the way, if you want to get back reviews and all the rest of it, ralphie.com, whiskey reviews, left-hand column, can't go wrong. All the past reviews are there, from 1 to 156. With whiskey, which the majority are, I tend to do it from memory, because I'm familiar with whiskey, but because I'm not such a dab hand at bourbon, I've actually been doing tasting notes. I shall read them out to you as I do some sniffing. Delightful, rounded, one of the best bourbons I've come across. Incidentally, this distillery didn't have a particularly successful year in 1996 when warehouses burnt down and over 90,000 litres of alcohol were lost to the flames. Oh dear, moving on quick. I don't even want to think about that. But they've survived and doing very well. They do a quite an eclectic range at Heaven Hill of different spirits, including all sorts of stuff. But Evan Williams is the other bourbon that I recommend that you look out for. Nose. Intense and complex. An immediate sense of quality, with fudgy corn, nuts, dried fruit, spice, cinnamon, and cumin. And a fragrant rye that ripples from the development in through the finish. Smoky honey and and vanilla cheesecake. That's just the nose. The taste. Mm. 47%, 94 proof. So we drop a water in here, we'll do wonders. This separates the also bourbons from the top notch bourbons, is when you add a drop of water, put a cap over the top, leave it half an hour, come back to it. How is it behaving? Is it growing? Is it softened? Is it mellowed? Is it retained that complexity? That's how you separate from the big bourbons from the wee bourbons. Taste. Steady arrival of spicy and infused grains, rich quality, evolving through an elegant fruit note and roast fig, almond marzipan into a rye fade. Bitter note runs through, salty molasses in the finish. There you have it. Delicious. Ralphie.com. See you soon. 91 out of 100. Bourbon Mark.